Thank you for joining this video about vision transformers. Up until vision transformers were invented, the dominated model architecture in computer vision was CNN, or convolutional neural network, which was invented in 1989 by famous researchers including Jan Luken and Joshua Benjo. In 2017, transformers were invented by Google and took the natural language processing domain by storm, but were not adapted successfully to computer vision up until 2020, when Google introduced vision transformers. Since then, vision transformers play a main role in the computer vision domain by being the architecture behind top models such as Dino V2, DEIT, and CLIP. In order to understand this important architecture, in this video we go back to the original vision transformers paper, titled An Image is Worth 16x16 Words, Transformers for Image Recognition at Scale. Before diving into how vision transformers work, let's first ask, why can't we simply feed a transformer with an image pixels? In the core of the transformer model we have self-attention, where each token is attending every other token in the input sequence. So, for an input sequence for example, here we have a sequence of 12 tokens, we would get a 12x12 matrix, which is called the attention matrix. This matrix has a quadratic dependency on the sequence length, which makes it difficult to scale up the context length. If we think about feeding an image into a transformer, then each pixel will need to attend all other pixels. Consider a low quality 255x255 image. In such an image we have 65k pixels, which will result in a 65k x65k attention matrix. Looking at a 512x512 image, which is still of low quality, we have 262k pixels and 262k x262k attention matrix. Just recently we've started to hear about models that can handle such long sequences, such as LongNet, and we're just talking about low quality images here. So handling images as is results in too long sequence lengths, which makes the solution not practical and not scalable. Okay, so how our vision transformers are able to deal with this issue? The main idea is that instead of feeding the image pixels in a sequence to the transformer, we break the image into patches, as we see in the example here. We then create a sequence of patches in order to feed that sequence to the transformer, similar to how we would feed a transformer with a sequence of tokens. In order to move the patches to the dimension which the transformer can work with, we pass them via a trainable linear projection layer that yields a vector for each patch with the dimension that match the transformer. Before feeding these vectors to the transformer, in order to retain the information about each patch location in the original image, positional embeddings are added to the linear projection output, which gives us the final patch embeddings for the input image, which we pass to the transformer, and from this point the transformer behaves as a regular transformer. In addition to the patch embeddings, we also add a special learnable embedding in the beginning of the sequence, and we use the transformer output for that embedding in order to predict the class of the input image. So this token learns to grasp global information about the image. Before moving on, if you enjoyed this content then please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button to help this channel grow. We also have a newsletter with 1-minute read summaries about the papers we review here. You may find the link to join in the description of this video. An interesting observation around vision transformer is its reduced inductive bias comparing to convolutional neural networks. With CNNs we have high inductive bias. For a given input, each part in the first layer has a local view on the input image, where each part looks at a different part of the image. In the following layer, each part has a local view about the previous layer output, but its receptive field is larger over the input image. And as we move towards the last layers, each part has a very wide receptive field, so it can take into account information from the entire image. So we provide a lot of guidance to the CNN model regarding how to process the image. This is unlike vision transformer, where thanks to self-attention each patch token can attend to any other token in every layer, so we provide much less guidance to the model. Even the positional embeddings are trained, so the model needs to learn them from scratch. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more reviews of AI papers.